Hello and welcome to the D5200 channel, the channel that we hope will bring you all the information you need about the Nikon D5200. Today we're looking at menus. We've had a brief look at the playback menu and now we're going to look at the shooting menu. The shooting menu is pretty basic, but it allows you to change most of the basic parameters for shooting your stills. And we're going to just have a quick overview through that menu right now. Okay, then let's have a look at the shooting menu. We are looking here at the back of the Nikon D5200, and if you want to get to any of the menus, then you press the menu button, which is at the top left, and that takes you to the menu settings. The shooting menu is the second one down on the left-hand side, and in order to get to the main menu, you press the right-hand pointer on the multi-selector tool. So here we are. The first option is to reset the shooting menu, which is the reset option is pretty much at the top of every option if that's what you want. The second one down is to identify the storage folder in which you want to put the pictures that you're about to take. On your memory card you can have pretty much as many folders as you like. You only have 5 alphanumeric digits though with which to name each folder, but you can have as many as you want. And that's for identifying where you want the pictures to go. Image quality we have looked at briefly already in the initiation setup, and we chose fine JPEG. You could have chosen RAW or RAW plus JPEG if that's what you want, but we're on fine JPEG at the moment. And likewise we chose in the initiation to have a large image size. White balance, again, we did in the initial setup phase, and we chose to leave that on auto rather than choose anything like fluorescent or tungsten. And the picture, the set picture control is a quite useful control once you get used to it and get to know it well. It allows you to either pump up the colour for vivid colours or to reduce the amount of saturation of colour and include a bit more grey into your images for things like neutral and standard. But that's something that we'll look at a bit later on. In order to manage your picture control, there is another option just below that. You have the option to have a manual picture control in there, so you can set up your own picture controls and decide how vivid, how neutral, or how grey you want any of your images to be. The auto distortion control, we normally recommend that you should switch off. That really deals with any distortion that there might be on the perimeter of your lens. There is another option to control the distortion a bit later on in another setting, which is far more advisable to use rather than just having it on automatic all the time. The color space, that talks about how much color there is in each picture. It sounds a bit odd, but there are different settings, and for some, particularly if you're looking to print in different particular formats, some formats require, well, basically more colour than others, and you can set the camera in order to decide which format you're going to be printing in, if that's what you wish, and set your camera accordingly. Active delighting below that is Nikon's way of dealing with high contrast images, and it improves the detail in dark images or darkened images or highly contrasted images, and that's a very useful thing to have, and we normally leave that on auto. High dynamic range images are very in vogue at the moment, and that allows you to shoot specifically in that style. And below that there is noise reduction for long exposure shots. As I'm sure you're aware, if you shoot something on a very long exposure, particularly in the dark, then there's a lot of noise very often in the frame and in the picture, and that noise reduction helps to reduce that level of noise when you're shooting that. Likewise, for the high ISO noise reduction, it's a similar thing. If you're shooting very high ISO, then you are likely to get more noise, and so you can set that as either off or on or normal or indeed high to reduce the amount of noise that's on that image. You can set the ISO sensitivity settings here as well. You can set The release mode, which obviously is the shutter release to single, continuous, or indeed any many others. And then you can shoot multiple exposure images. Now that gives you the option to shoot two or three separate images and then basically merge them together. They're the sort of pictures that you get of ghostly people walking down the stairs, that kind of thing. And then we move on to the interval timer. Now the interval timer allows you to shoot at separate stated intervals. So for example, you could shoot a single frame from this camera every so many seconds, regardless of whether you're actually standing behind it pressing the shutter or not, it will do that automatically. And that can be useful for certain things. And then finally we get onto the bottom one, which is movie settings. Now all of these settings we will go into in more detail, but this is just a rough overview of the shooting menu that you can see here. And as I say, later on, we'll have a look at all of them a bit more closely.